Well, hello everyone, I'm Jenny from BeauView Gaming, and today we're back in Mercury Fallen, and I was just waiting here for my little beetle miner to finish mining some more sand, and then we actually have the whale miner, which I don't even remember if I didn't notice if it got finished last time when we were during the video, or if it just did afterwards, because I did have it running a little bit, after the video. So let's just finish you off. Come on, you're running out of power or something. Perhaps it is nighttime. Well, you should have power. Oh, did I pause or something by accident? Maybe I did. There we go. Okay, but anyway, you can see we have structure resin, bioplastic cloth, we have some glass, we have silicon carbide being produced now, so that is awesome. Why am I not making, was that not for the no, that was for the processors. Yes, okay, it's because we don't have any more gold, but we do have these advanced scanners, and actually they only give, let's see, they give scan time -25%, and the improved scanners give -10%. So I was like, okay, that can't be what we need for the blue fish, and it turns out I have completely missed something when I've been doing the mining here. Let's see, you still don't want to do anything. Yeah, okay, there we go, updated 0.56. it's because it is nighttime. But we can deploy this, so here's our little whale miner, look at that, and that one of course can go across the water, so I think that's what we should do. Maybe we'll go to this blue meadow. Yeah, let's do that. Let's go over here. And that will give us, what will that give us? Mineral compound and anthracite. Not really what we're after. Let's see if we can find something over here we want. A sand, hematite, always handy. We can get, we can get some gold here. Wasn't there a really good place for gold down here somewhere? Yeah, down here in the tundra. Okay, I think we're gonna go down here then. Let's see, 16.1, 15.9. 16.1, 16.2. Yeah, okay. I think we're gonna go for one of these that has like 16 point something. Oh, where are you? Oh, there you are. Okay. Let's see. I want you to go down here. Yeah, 16.2. So we're gonna go down here and mine some gold because we need some of that. And I think, did we finish our little mining project? Yes, we did. So let's just bring you back home. Oh, I should have done something. Okay, well, trying to keep track of everything and learn all the new features and stuff, guys. Let's try and speed this up. There we go. And now we can, first of all, we can offload, and then we should be able to do this. Vehicle must be docked to install equipment. How do I dock? Can I dock you? Do I have to install equipment before, or dock at facility? Oh, okay, we're gonna dock you. There we go. And then we can go in here. Improved engine, movement speed +50. That would be handy because, man, they move slowly, these miners. And improved mining laser, so 10%. Okay, we don't have a better one, so I think we're just gonna give it this one. And then we can give it an improved engine. So you can't stack the laser, that's good to know, but we can make it faster. Aha, so that is installed, and now we're just waiting for this to be installed. There we go, nice. So let's just deploy it again. And then I'm thinking, where was it that we found some rutile? Two over there. There was somewhere where we could get EF5. I don't remember if there was one that was better. I have to start writing this stuff down, guys. 3.6%. Okay, I think we're just gonna go for the 5% right now, which is down here. 5.2, 5.1, 5.2. Yes, so we are gonna send you down there to do some mining. And that's what I should have done with the whale miner before I send it off. Of course, I should have docked it again and then added some equipment. But hey-ho, we are learning, we are learning. Let's just bring you over here. Should be almost there. Okay. Yep, nice. So let's click on you. And then we are gonna mine. Okay, that can actually carry 200. So apart from it being able to go over water, it can also carry twice as much as the little beetle miner. So that's really handy. It's better to use this one for like the close stuff, like getting sand and stuff. Then we have our wasp, which I moved to... Where are you? There we go. Yep, an unknown biome. And before we scan this, well, we can scan it, guys. Let's just scan it. But if we go to discoveries, here's what I had completely missed. We have apparently discovered 60% of the biome. So, wow, look at this. We have this many, and apparently there's 40% more. So, what is that? Maybe 10 more we have to get find or something like that. Before we reach 100% of the biome. So there's still a lot to scan. But then, since I couldn't find out the thing with the blue fish, I was looking at research, first of all, because we needed the blue fish for this. But then I figured there's also other discoveries, so I was kind of clicking around here, and you can see, for instance, we need green algae. But if we click on this, required discoveries, lumen bulbous. So we have discovered some of this. We have the arrowhead fungus. We have that one we found. We have the wheat thorn. So apparently we have some of this. We have the sponge top. And I think I've completely missed that when we have been scanning. You can also see it under here. Flora, 57%. So we have these four different ones. It doesn't help us much until we get the blue fish, of course. And that is just the thing with R&D, that I haven't found the blue fish yet. But it seems like it's just random when you are exploring or scanning on these that you have a chance of making a discovery. And yeah, biome scan complete. So this one gives us anthracite mineral compound and around 11% unrefined gold. So that's also a decent one. But of course, for gold, it's much better with the tundra. But that means we should definitely do some more scanning. I don't know, because I haven't noticed. You probably noticed in my previous videos when I got these discoveries. I assume it would show up here. It would pop up like a little discovery thing. But I was, of course, looking down here because I was looking at this text that you have down here. And that's why I expected that it would say that on this biome we found whatever it is. But I don't know if it's based on biome. I don't know if it's like you have to, if it's the tendril forest that has a chance of giving you a certain, you know, discovery, or if you can just get it on any of the tiles. I have no idea, or if any biome has a chance of giving you it. So that's something where I would have to start a new game and then actually pay more attention when I'm scanning, because now I know what I have to look out for. And then, you know, see, okay, from game to game, what do I actually get? Like, if I play several different games and I scan different ones, do I always get the discovery on the same type of tile? I don't know. Or we could ask Tim, of course, but where's the fun in that? Anyway, that was our little wasp. There we go. Let's go here. And wow, my frames per second are like going crazy low right now. I don't know why. But let's just kind of, let's send you through here. And then let's go to this little fellow, which I kind of sent up here a little bit. And a shrubland, fungal forest, blue meadow. Doesn't look like there's something here that we haven't. Okay. And again, it is random, you know. It's procedurally generated, this map. So you never know what you get. And that's, of course, also why there's this, you know, chance of getting these discoveries. You never know where you're gonna get them. Okay, level 4 engineer, that's nice. But I'm thinking let's just scan this since we are here anyway. Oh, I'm clicking on it. Come on. You don't... That's this guy. Okay, why do you not want to biomes? Oh, of course. Oh, it must be. Of course, it must be based on the biome then, because you can't scan something you already scanned. So I guess it's a specific biome you have to find. Because otherwise, technically, there's a chance you won't find any of discoveries. If it's based on, you know, random chance on whatever biome it is you scan, then eventually you'll get 100%. Biomes found, and then you can't scan anymore. So it has to be a specific biome, right? Yeah, so I guess we just have to have to find some of these other biomes. So let's go up this way. So that's gonna be a little bit of a hunt, guys. We're gonna have to try and see if we can find these biomes. And you, did I mine down here? No, I didn't. So let's just get you started on mining. Hey, but this is the fun part when you are doing something with or learning the new stuff in a game, either a new game or when it's a new update for an early access game and there's new changes, you know, then you have to try and figure all the new features out, which is cool. I'm not really seeing anything new here. Let's see, tundra, boreal shrub, tundral forest. No, not really. There's a lot of water out here, so that might be an idea to go out that way, since this one can go above over the water. There we go. Wow, my frames per second are down to 12. I don't know if it's because they're mining or something, that it just, wow, goes down like severely. Okay, well, let's get back down here. Yeah, because now my frames, well, you guys can't see, but I can see it from Steam. Of course, I have that little frames per seconds overlay, so it's actually up to like 80 at the moment. So there's definitely something with the map. I don't know why it goes down so low. Okay, so we have our little dip miner here being busy, so let's just make sure that it is always mining. There we go. But yeah, that will have to be like the priority. I just have to keep, you know, looking for new areas. We still have this entire half of the map that we haven't actually checked, so that you can see if we can find this elusive blue fish. But there is some balancing coming, because I so have seen Tim mentioning that too, that there's some rebalancing that he's going to be doing with this, and you know how you get discoveries and stuff. So this is not like the final deal. We're just gonna have to wait and see what happens. So I have these three things left that we can research, so let's just do that. There we go. Did we finish another clone? Yes, we did. So let's grow another one and let's see what did we get this time. That's because you got equipment. There must be you, right? Yeah, so 4, 6, and 5. Okay, that is not very amazing, but what do I need? What's the highest level I need in smarts? I need 8 for a doctor, which means I need to get a clone with 6 if I want to get someone that is smart enough. Because I could leave this person as a doctor, I probably will leave it as it is, but it would be nice to have someone who just has that as their job, you know. But then we need to get a smarter one, because we can only add 2 with smarts. Which technically means I could make you into a doctor too. No, I can't, because you're not going to be smart enough. And you can only go up to 4. You can go up to 6, so we do need another clone if we want to have a doctor. We have a scientist. And now we have someone becoming a pure engineer here. Then you are a botanist. It might be nice to have someone who has that else. You know, our beginning crew is probably gonna keep having, you know, especially these that have high levels, just having various things that they do. But for the clones, it might be nice. See, you already have... Wow, no, that's not a clone. Where's the other one? You are a clone. Why are you up there now? Did I set you to also be a botanist? I don't remember doing that. That is peculiar. Did I tell you to... I think you're gonna set you to none. I think they've moved around, because before all the original crew was up here and we had like the clones down here. But you were up there before. Okay, so you are doing this, you're kind of doing the same. Ooh, this guy, he has 7. Ha 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 ha, he could actually become a doctor. 7, 8, and 7. Wow, he's actually really good. Yep, I think that's what we're gonna do with you guys. You need to do something better. Let's see, we're gonna give you some of everything here, since we can't stack it. There we go. Let's just get all of this installed. There we go. He's already smarter. Now he's faster. So let's click here. You are now going to be a doctor. He has a 50% success chance. There we go. That's going to be your main job. Then we could let him do something else. We don't really need a second scientist, really. Because we can't really keep up with doing everything anyway that we research. And we don't have that much left. So, we could leave him to just be a doctor, of course, and say that's just his job. Is there anything else that needs high? Not really. The second highest is the scientist, and then everybody else doesn't really need that much, so... We could just let you have that as your, and then we can switch this around and say you are gonna be like our scientist. That's your main job. And see, there's so little they have had to do, so you know, this is the only doctor we have, and she's still only level one. So yeah, I think we're gonna put engineering as your second job. There we go. And then I think we're just gonna remove this. Okay, so you do these two jobs. If you're not researching, then you can help out with engineering since you have a high level. And then he is just gonna be doctoring. That's the only thing, I guess. We're gonna leave. We could give him something else, but... And you are gonna be an engineer, so we have pure that. You are kind of technically pure that. Then we have... You're a botanist. It would be nice to have someone else who is like... a pure botanist. You are our new one, right? Yeah, you must be. Can you be a botanist? What if we say you're just gonna be a botanist and nothing else? They cancel. And then of course we can always kind of give you some equipment. There we go. Eventually we can make even, we can get even better. And there we go. Let's remove this. See, now my frames per second are really low again. It's every time I'm in a menu. I don't know why. Okay, so engineer, botanist, of course we have someone else who's doing that. So that means we are gonna remove it here. You're just gonna be a cook. Yes. Do we have any other? Well, you're primarily a miner. And you are, of course, full miner. You are a hauler. Don't really have a person who's a full hauler, but you're mainly a hauler. And you are like our little builder. We're not building that much, we don't technically need it that much. Yeah, let's say none. You are just gonna be hauling all the time. And of course we're gonna get more people, which means we should probably add some more bits, right? Not that they look that occupied, but I guess everybody likes to have their own bed, right? So let's put a bed right there. We can put a bed right there. Not sure I want to put a bed right there. I think we're gonna leave that open for something else. And then we could... Well, we can put a bed right there. Yeah, okay, let's do it. Can't wait until we get even more decorative stuff and things. Then I would probably make it even different with the bed, you know, because if we get like bookshelves and stuff that you can put in, that would be kind of nice. Or if you make a recreational area, I don't know if it's gonna be limited to specific rooms, but things like that, I hope not, because it would be kind of cool if you could make like a little library area almost, you know. Then you can make this bigger and then have like some bookshelves, and if we got a little, hopefully get a little table of sorts or something, and you know, then you can book some bookshelves, kind of a little nice area for people to hang out in, right? That could be cool. Okay, what else are we doing? And let's see, how are we doing? You are still being grown. What are we missing more than anything? We have plenty of azurite. We need more storage, guys. I think that's really the thing. See, they are all full. I haven't actually kind of sorted all of this. Where do we want to have storage? Let's see. Could be handy with some storage in here. Why did I put you in the middle and not some, so we could put two of them? That's interesting. I think I misplaced that without knowing. Let's put this here. And let's put a storage next to this. Gonna have to figure out what we want in these areas. Do we need anything in here? Not really. Food. Well, that goes into these storages. This one doesn't need storage. This doesn't need storage. This doesn't. There's not that much we need storage for apart from this. And technically, I would like to have more of these machines, actually. Maybe we should start doing that as we get more people. And I would like more engineers, actually. So let's say by refiner. Okay, let's see. Yeah, that is this one. I just felt like it looked different. Okay, there we go. And then another ore refiner. Like this. And then I actually want one more of these, which I technically wanted right next to it, but I think we're just gonna put one over here. Yeah, we could also put it like this just to make it a little different. Yes. And what would we want in here? I know it's kind of a little operational area, so it's like, you know, you do stuff, but let's just give them some plants anyway. I did kind of suggest to them that maybe we could get like a tool. Well, I guess you call it a tool rack. I call it a tool hanger. I don't know. I think you can call it that too, but I guess it's also called a tool rack, you know, that you could hang on the wall. Just as a decorative item, that could be kind of neat. Okay, that was fast. We're getting that built. Okay, awesome. So we're gonna need power, of course. Let's see, oh, come on, power. Yep, just need to do something like that. That should give us power for that. And there's actually already power underneath these, so that is cool. Okay. Then let's figure out what we want to do when it comes to, let's give you some potatoes in there, let's put some hemp in here. And because we could choose to say one of them produces one kind of items and another one another kind of items. So if we take this one and let's remove the all the equipment from here. There we go. This. Well, we could let them do everything, but you know what? I think we're just gonna, because this is making me confused, because we can do so many things in here now. So if we go in here and say, we have most of the storage over here. Look, we can do like colonist equipment, machine equipment, vehicle equipment, and tech. Wow. Okay, let's say we want to do tech. So we have electronics. Would be nice if we had... well, I guess 100 of everything. But we do kind of need a lot of it. Would be nice if it remembered what the last thing was that you had added here, so you don't have to switch it every time. Just a little, you know, a little detail. Okay, so we have processors. I don't think we need that many processors, actually. Let's change that one. I think we're just gonna have like 10 of them or something. We need gold for that. Then we are gonna go here again, say tech. Then we have fasteners. Well, we need like 50 of those every time we need something. So let's say 100. And then we are gonna do... We have the hardened fasteners and... Okay, we're gonna say 50, But we're gonna pause that one immediately. So where are you? Right there. Let's pause you because it takes titanium. Which I needed for something else. So that's why I don't have any titanium, because I had this set and they kept making these instead of and we don't have that much rutile yet. Okay, let's do this, and then we are gonna do tick again and patch kits. Okay, patch kits. Let's see, what do you do? Can't see that in here. Okay, craft if below. Let's just say we want to have 10 of those. And check, patch kit, a small repair kit used to repair machinery. Okay, well, now we have it set to 10. Someone is already crafting them. Awesome. Did we have any more tech in here? Repair kit. Okay, that seems to be better. Or use different. Okay, let's say 10. So what's the difference? A more efficient repair kit used to repair machinery. But it takes copper ingots, it takes steel, it's pretty expensive. We have steel ingots and copper ingots. Yeah, so it shouldn't really be a problem having both. I guess they'll always use this if it's available. I don't know if they're that smart. If they have this one, will they always do take the better one? That's the question. Because otherwise I wouldn't want to have these if they would just take whatever, but I assume they will go for the better one. Okay, so that's everything we can make with that. So let's go into this one. And then we have different types of equipment. So, let's see. I wish you could see it in here exactly what they do, instead of having to craft them first. Or put them in your... Okay, back brace, sturdy frame, comfy shoes, because I assume one of them is better than the other one, or what? Let's see. Guide. We've got to research. And we go to this equipment. So, what's the difference? Back brace. Okay, it doesn't even show in here. But that's the smart, faster, and stronger. And... I guess some of them are for the little robots and some of it are for the normal... Okay, and then we have the better stuff. Let's just start research. Apparently we finished researching. Yeah, then we can make even better stuff. Which I'm not sure if we can afford yet. Because then we might want to do that instead of adding... this stuff. Let's see, machine equipment. Oh, look at that. We have advanced power supply. That would probably be better. What do we need for that? We need electronics. Let's say we always want to have one of those in storage. Because then whenever I craft something new or I want to improve it, then I can put some of these, right? So let's just always have one. Then we have, what was that, machine. So, advanced inlet valve that takes rubber. I have to find out where to make rubber because we're not making any of that. Okay, let's just say one of those. Then we have, craft efficiency 2. That would probably be a good idea. For this, we need the processors. Okay, so let me make sure we always have at least one of those. And then we have the... Okay. Improved advanced power coil. That takes gold. We definitely need to go and get some gold, guys. So let's say we always want to have one of those in storage. Maybe we want to have more, but let's see. Machine equipment again. That was the power coil, right? Then we need advanced pump motor. Oh, we need processors again for that. Good to know. So I want one of those. And last but not least, I think. Oh, straight. Oh, that map display nodes. Modes. What is that? I don't know. We're gonna have to find out. We need to make some rubber. So let's say we want a straight expander. Actually, let's just say we want to have five of those for now. Okay. And then there was that last thing for the machine equipment. So map display modes. Display mode options for planet map installed in map table. Okay, I've no idea what that is, but I don't know if we need more than one. So let's just say apply. Ew. Okay, display mode options. Display mode options. Okay. No idea what that's about. Okay, and then of course we have all the other stuff. We're gonna get better colonists. Do we have better if we do? Okay, let's just start with that for now. And we did add some more storage, so of course I'm gonna have to decide what I want to allow, but I'm gonna kind of try and compare a little bit and see what we need. Like, we don't want these basic things in here. And then we should probably have some extra storage just for overflow. So where would we want? Well, for instance, out here would be handy. Kind of right next to this. There. Because it's still next to this area, right? So then we can have like some basic storage. So it's not just lying on the ground. Let's put a storage over there, and maybe just have a little storage there. We can have one in this corner. Yep, and I'm gonna sort those out and figure out what I want in all of them, because all of this just kind of takes time. I guess this one broke. Yes, they just need to repair it. Oh boy. Okay. So what are we doing out here? Well, we have our little beetle miner, which is four. So we need to see, you can see how amazing this is going to be once you can do I have this running on tree? There we go. Once we would be able to set up auto transport routes, that would be awesome. Oh, look at this, guys. There's a new biome right there. There's just that one little one. Okay, so let's take you, wasp, and we're gonna move you back down here so that we can scan it. That was the wasp. You are idle. What are you doing? I have the tundra, fungal forest, boiled shrub. Not seeing anything here that looks like something we haven't explored before. No. Okay. So we are gonna give you a little trip. Let's just kind of, okay, let's send you up here. I think there's some water out here. So let's go to a wasp again. And please give me my fish. So, biome scan. And, no, that's research complete. Colonist gear 2. So, see. Okay, biome scan complete. It didn't tell me anything. Twisted jungle. Hematite and mineral compound. Let's see, discoveries. We had 68% for biome, so we have the twisted jungle and polar wasteland. Oh, cool, so it shows us here which ones are new. We have 71% flora, so we got the crimson balloon from something. I guess that was from the twisted jungle. So it doesn't seem to, or did it pop up when we scanned this? I'm not sure. So I guess you just have to go in here and check if you got something new, maybe. I'm not sure exactly how it all works, guys. This is really, 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 really a learning process. So, wasp, let's send you out on another trip. Where are we? Well, actually, it looks like we found some of it there. There's also the twisted jungle. I guess I didn't notice that when I brought my little... That's the problem when you bring them up too far. Okay, let's send you out this way, or send them on too long of a trip. Then I didn't check far enough back, so let's see. Did you find anything here? Fungal desert. Royal. No. Polar wasteland. Fresh water. Have the tundra. Polar wasteland. No. Okay. Beetle miner. We are back home, so we can load off some stuff. Then we have our little whale miner, which is full, so we are gonna send you back home, and then I have to see if I can remember to install some new items. There we go, beetle miner. Wow, you're already emptied. What equipment did we have in that one? Movement speed and mining time. Because I might want to change that. What do I have? Let's go back here and check. When it comes to equipment. Machine equipment. Here. That's much better. Okay, improved engine. Movement speed plus 50. That would be much better. And then a scanner, then we have to bring our little doge back home, or whatever you call it. Improved mining laser, we already have that. And improved scanner. The advanced one would be handy. But we don't have the cargo one. I don't think I set it to produce those, actually. If we go in here, vehicle equipment. See, there's a cargo expander. Let's see, cargo expander 2. Again, we need the rubber. Let's just say 2 of these for starters, and then we have to find out where in the world was the rubber. No, that's metal. Then we have refined organic. How do we need? Is it in here? Oh. Item order structure. No. Maybe it's something we have to. Oh, which one is it? Research. Is there one of these that gives us. There we go. Lumen. Okay, that gives us rubber. Yeah, okay. So, but we still need to find a bluefish, guys. I think I'm just gonna be doing a bunch of exploring until we find that blue fish, and then we're gonna have to continue because we have almost everything else. We still need the tangle fruit and the green algae, and we need to research science. Yeah, but that's this one. Okay. What are we doing? Man. Oh, there's the wasp again. Not seeing anything here. That looks new. So, I guess if we just say wasp like this, where is home on this map? It's way over here. So, I'm thinking, what if we send you out just kind of this way? Straight towards home, then it's gonna open up some of this, and hopefully we'll find something new, and then we can add some stuff to it, like the improved scanner, so it scans faster, for instance. Then we have this one, which also didn't seem to find anything new. No. Okay, so just make sure that's the one I have. Ocean. There we go. It looks like there's a lot of water out here, but we could kind of send you through here, try and send you downwards. So there we go. Did I get you started? Yes, I did. It's moving. It's moving. Then we are back to our miner, which we emptied out, right? Yep. And I didn't want to put anything in it, so let's just go over here and see if we can get some sand. Mine. There we go. You're going to be mining. Then we have our little whale miner. You have to drop off stuff. Ooh, okay, well, we got like 26 gold. That's not a lot, but it's a beginning. But you can imagine how much you're gonna have to move around here. So I really love that idea that we're gonna be getting a way to set up like some automatic stuff, transport back and forth, so you don't have to do this all the time. There we go. Now we want you to, I think we're gonna go and see if we can get some more of this rutile. Where was that? That was down here, right? Yes. So I'm gonna send it down here. Get some rutile. And how are you doing? Oh, there's something right there, unknown biome, before we end the video. Oh, and there's actually an unknown biome up here. Aha, that's the problem when you go this far. But at least now we know where it is. So come on. Yep, there we go. And okay, I'm just gonna go and do this so we can see if we might get lucky and get what we want. But otherwise I would want to add scanner, but we have so little left to scan, so I don't really feel like an improved scanner is really matters that much at this point. How do you? Because then we have to go all the way back home to add it. And yeah, that's not gonna make a huge difference at this point. There we go. Then it should more be the movement when they move around the map, but also that doesn't really matter much. So there we go. What did we? Biome scan complete. Well, it didn't tell me that I learned anything new. Hematite, anthracite. Oh, rutile, 10.8%. Scorched lands. Yep, we definitely want to send someone over here, guys. So what are we doing? We're mining here. Instead of you mining down. Oh, well, you might as well mine down here, right? While we're here, but then I would want to send it to the other one. But here's where I really would wish that there was a way that you could, you know, mark this, so I don't have to remember it all the time, that this is where we had it. Oh, this is the one we wanted. But maybe with those map modes we can do something different, I don't know. Let's go, where was it? Yep, let's go up there. And where is my little... It is here. Oh, did you run out of power or something? Yes, you did. Okay. Fair enough. Nothing new here. Okay, but let's just check our discoveries. We're still at 71%, so learn nothing new there. We're at 72% here. So there's still quite a few we need to find. Oh, you don't have any more to do, I think. No. But it really, it is different, you know, in the beginning you're so busy, like, mining and building, and then you reach this point where most of the time you're just kind of micromanaging, figuring out what you want to, where you want to put things in storage and move your miners around and stuff. So I really look forward to this new update, which is gonna get add more stuff to work with on the surface, and kind of it's a nice feeling to be able to work towards being able to automate some things, right? There we go. Just a little bit of that. Let's see where our little wasp is and see what we get. What is this? Shadow Forest. Okay, scan. Come on, give me that blue fish. Give me the blue. Okay, biome scan complete. And that's actually a swamp. That's something with water. Look at that flora, 86%. Green. Oh, we got green algae. Still no bluefish. Seriously? Oh man, look at that. We got four new. We still have some to find. Okay. Well, I am gonna kind of sort out all this storage things and figure out where I want to place things, and then I'm gonna keep exploring until we get the bluefish, I think. And then that's when I'm gonna record some more, guys. Because otherwise it's just gonna be more and more of this, which is fine for me, but I don't know how interesting it is for you guys to sit and watch me do this. And then I'm gonna, you know, bring my stuff around here and mine some things, because I really want to get into all of this biology stuff that we can do, and we can't do a thing until we get the blue fish. And yeah, oh, there's actually a new biome right there. Man, I'm never gonna be able to end this video because I want you guys to be, you know, be part of it when we find this. There we go. Which of course is hard because I don't know what we're gonna get. So let's just check it and then we're gonna end this because these videos are getting so long. I'm sorry about that, but it's so hard to stop playing once you are doing this. So biome scan, see, it doesn't give us any pop-ups. So that kind of also explains why I didn't notice, you know, when I find a discovery, because it doesn't actually tell you when, you know, when you find something. You have to go in here and check, which is a little strange. Okay, we didn't actually scan it, but still. Unknown biome, scanning required. But at least I haven't noticed it pop up anywhere. Have you guys noticed? Am I missing it somewhere on the screen when we get something new? I don't know. But this is arid plains. Okay, anthracite and azurite, more or less half and half. But apart from that, it doesn't tell me anything. Surface mining. Okay, did we learn anything new? We did! Okay, that was the floor. Oh, there we go, fauna. Did we already get it before and I didn't notice that it said fauna down here because I was so busy looking at the flora, which of course is not the same. But we got it today because we have a yellow thingy here. But anyway, we got the blue fish finally. I'm so confused. I'm gonna have to play through this game again. Oh man. Okay, well, we have 100% blueprints. We have 80% biomes, so that is cool. I'll have to watch my video to find out when exactly we got that fauna. There we go. We have, oh, we got 100% that slugs. So the only thing I just need to do is scan more biomes. But we can finally get into this. Look at this, guys. Yep, let's just start researching. So xenobiology, yes, nice. That is what we're gonna look into next time. I'm so excited and I can't wait until we get another update for this. That's gonna be exciting to be able to do more stuff on the surface. So thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.